The next objection comes from Leibniz and similar experiments. In the early 1980s, researcher Benjamin Leibniz had subjects hooked up to a machine to measure their brain activity while they were asked to randomly decide to press a button. The subjects were asked to know when they consciously decided to press the button. He then found that prior to them becoming consciously aware of when they decided to press the button, there was a buildup of brain activity, later titled the readiness potential. Later studies saw this buildup 10 seconds prior to a conscious decision. Others deduced from this research, this means the brain is the cause of conscious activity, because the buildup of the readiness potential was occurring prior to our conscious decisions. Well, there were several problems with this. Later research has demonstrated the readiness potential was present even when subjects did not make any conscious decisions. If the supposed readiness potential is present even when decisions are not being made, then it couldn't be a cause of conscious decisions. This was confirmed in several separate studies, thereby debunking the idea the readiness potential was causing conscious decisions. In one 2008 study, subjects were told they had to press a button when they saw a cube, among many other distracting shapes like circles, triangles, or hexagons. Simultaneously, their brain activity was measured. It was found that the readiness potential was present even before the stimuli appeared on the screen. In other words, the readiness potential was present even before the stimuli appeared in which subjects did not make a conscious intention to move. Our results show that neural activity, which is present prior to motor responses, emerges well before the presentation of a stimulus. At that time, the participants were not capable of knowing whether to press the left hand or the right hand button before a stimulus appeared. In addition, the activation preceding the stimulation did not differ significantly between the two response alternatives. Thus, the observed activity cannot be regarded as a specific preparation to press one of the buttons rather than the other one. Thus, the readiness potential could not be a cause of a conscious decision to move. However, even if it was causing brain activity, Leibniz responded to his own work, as he still held to a belief in free will. He suggested from later research of his own, the brain activity would act on its own, but the mind had the ability to interfere and veto the buildup or the readiness potential from carrying out a decision. In other words, the brain will run on autopilot and carry out tasks, but the mind or the self has the ability to interfere by preventing the activity from being carried out. Sort of like how in everyday life we sometimes do things without thinking. Also, think of Ward's earlier analogy of comparing the brain to a CD. The brain would continue to play on its own until the mind stops it. Leibniz suggested that there exists conscious cerebral cortex activity that may be blocking or vetoing the volitional process so that no actual motor action occurs. This has been called the mind's ability to free won't and take control of the brain activity by preventing it from going forward. This is cited by neuroscientist Jeffrey Schwartz in his book, The Mind and the Brain, as further evidence of his own research, which I cited in my last video. So just to quickly recap, Schwartz worked with patients who suffered from OCD and had them engage in the act of mindful attention, which over time changed the chemical pathways in the brain and reduced OCD symptoms. The mind had the ability to causally affect and change the brain, which is the same thing Leibniz concluded from his own research. If the brain actually was causing decisions to be made through the readiness potential, and the supposed evidence for it doesn't even hold up, one could still argue from the research of Leibniz and Schwartz to demonstrate the mind has the ability to interfere and produce real changes in the brain as a final gatekeeper to if a decision is to be carried out or stopped.